That's so true.
Yeah. That's back when you used to play like CDs and stuff, and you had to know that crap. Oh. Throwback Thursday, it's the Woody Show.
Now, back to the Woody Show.
All right, Gina Grad, what are the trending news headlines today?
Well, we have a lot coming out of followupnewsdesk.com today, and it includes a lot of bad people. First off, Jose Ibarra, the guy on trial for Lake and Riley's murder, has been found guilty.
Good.
He was charged with murder, kidnapping.
You knew that was going to happen.
Absolutely. Aggravated assault and other crimes, and could receive a life sentence. Video and audio evidence played a big role in this trial because there was a video of Jose unable to tell cops how he ended up with fresh scratches and marks on his arms just hours after the murder.
Yeah, dude, heartbreaking. I was watching some of the coverage yesterday, and her mom and dad got to make statements.
Oh, boy.
And her, like, the victim sister, impact. Her roommates. Yeah, I listened to all of that.
Yeah, see, I didn't. The mom and dad, the dad especially.
I heard the dad. That, so awful.
Heart
crushing. That one hit harder.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, prosecutors played a clip that showed him tossing a bloody sweatshirt into a dumpster as well. So I don't think there was any way out for this guy.
You know what the thing is about the dad? When the dad was saying, like, you know, for the rest of my life, I know that I wasn't able to be there when she needed me the most. Like, and I thought about my own daughter, and, like, you know, you always want to make sure you can be there to
protect
them or guide them or whatever. And, you know, in those moments, they really, like, that would, I think, would haunt. I mean, it's good. Look, anytime you lose a child or, but the fact as a dad and your just natural instinct, especially with daughters or whatever, to protect them against, you know, people or things like this.
This is
like,
why,
that's awful.
Yeah, it's so bad. And this is why when people are up for parole, I always hope and pray they don't get it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
They don't deserve it.
It's like, why? Yep.
Just because time has passed and they've become a new person.
And you're a model prisoner and you put all your clothes away.
Who, like, what's the other one? What's her name?
Susan Smith? Let's talk about her.
Yeah, because she's like, well, you know, I'm a changed person and I've found God. And
who cares?
And I know God's forgiven me. Well, good for God.
I hate that as well. Like, well, guess what? We're here now and we don't forgive you.
You killed your kids.
Exactly. Yep. Let's talk about Susan Smith. She's the one that drowned her two sons in South Carolina 30 years back. She was denied parole in her very first hearing. At first, Smith claimed her children were kidnapped, but later confessed to the murders.
She says, this is a black guy.
Yep, exactly.
Black guy kidnapped these kids, and he's the one who, like,
At the hearing, Smith looked remorseful, while her ex-husband and the prosecutor urged the board to keep her locked up. Smith, who's now 53, will be eligible for another parole hearing in 2 years.
Okay. I don't know why we waste time with even just the dog and pony show of it.
I know.
Like, I don't think they're ever going to let her out.
Well, and that's the thing. Uh-huh. Why keep putting the victims through this? Like, I can't put this behind me. I got to go back and make sure she doesn't get out again. But she's been a model. Oh, I'm sorry. She has not been a model prisoner. She's been busted on the inside for sexual misconduct, for drug possession. So I think she's probably where she needs to be.
Why waste your time with
There's this former guard who was banging her.
That's exactly right.
Even he said her tears in the parole hearing were utter BS.
Wow.
Wow.
And he would
take it where you can get it.
He would know.
He would know. He had sex with her once.
He knows her intimately.
Yeah, he did, like, extra research.
Yeah, that guy would really know.
Well, let's talk about an update on Seabass's doppelganger. The Idaho killer, Brian Kohlberger. He stabbed and killed those four University of Idaho students back in 2022. His lawyers have requested that the death penalty be thrown out because they say the death penalty is, quote, out of step with current social customs.
Was he found guilty already?
His trial hasn't even started.
Did he confess?
No. The trial hasn't even started.
So we have to say allegedly.
I think it's next year. No, he did it.
Bad news. That request was denied to have that thrown out.
Oh, no.
So the death penalty back on the table and the case moves forward. Trial scheduled for August of 2025. Allegedly.
No, he definitely did it.
Yeah. Liam Payne, his funeral was finally held yesterday in England with his family and One Direction bandmates there. The 31-year-old singer died back on October 16th in Argentina. Remember, he fell from a third-floor balcony at a hotel. A horse-drawn carriage carrying Payne's casket was brought into a private service.
So was he, I mean, there was a casket, but was he cremated? What do they do with the body? Because that was forever ago.
I know. What is
it? Well, I've always wondered that. Like, when somebody dies and then, I mean, the Jews, they do it the right way.
I was going to say, we don't mess around.
It's within 24 hours.
It's quick.
It's really quick.
Very quick. Pine box, no embalming, get him back in the ground.
Yeah, but when somebody dies and then the funeral's not till weeks later.
Yeah.
There's ways to keep
it. No, they put it on ice, don't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's right. So Bort's Bort's wife, she's a Undertaker.
Oh yeah, yep. We have all of this knowledge at our fingertips.
Yes. So Bort. I mean, you know more about this. It's just like in a refrigerator, but like why? I don't understand. Like why?
Depends on if they're doing an embalming or not. But if there is an embalming, they'll get the authorization for that, embalm them right away, and then put them on ice as long as they can.
So I guess I've never really asked any kind of specific questions. So your wife, her job isn't like just to do their hair and makeup, right? I mean, like she's actually doing like embalming and stuff.
She's done everything. Yeah, embalming, cremations, everything.
Wow.
Disinterments, that's most of the more freaky of anything. That's when family members like, hey, we want to move this person from this cemetery across the country to another cemetery. So they have to,
remove them. Have they done any of the cool stuff where it looks like they're still riding a motorcycle?
They're playing poker.
drinking a martini or something.
Yeah.
Defending their goalie.
I wish that'd be something. That'd be something fun, right?
Yeah.
Nothing like that?
Nothing too much. I think there's been like one where it's kind of that way, but not too much.
What creeps her out? Well, you know, is there anything like butterflies for Greg? Or
right.
Like when you do that for a job, is there anything that just creeps that creeps her out or turns her stomach? Or
probably bugs. So like the exhuming, the disinterments, because if things kind of go wrong, so like when they put them in the ground, there's usually a vault, like a
concrete kind
of. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But those can break over time. And if they do, then they get water in them from the ground. And then usually there's maggots and stuff like that.
So, nice.
That's the kind of thing that creeped her out, and she can't. No.
Yeah.
My favorite story about Bort's wife is because she has to get dead bodies presentable for an open casket funeral, and she knows how to do makeup and whatnot.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Friends who have asked her, can you do my makeup for my wedding?
Oh, yeah.
She'll say, I can, but I'm going to need you to lie down.
Are you serious?
Yeah, that's the only way she could do makeup on other people.
Yeah, wow. Her best friend had to lay down, like, before her wedding.
It's so funny.
Made up, yeah.
Awesome. That makes perfect sense.
Isn't that
it's like tying a necktie on a guy.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Greg's made comments about the way you write. Like, you have to turn the paper a completely different way.
Almost completely upside down.
And that's just because of, so the same kind of thing. That's just how you have to do it. It's the way you know to do it.
Yeah, I can do it. Pretend you're dead. Just lie down.
Does she ever have that with you? Like, she just tells you, like, pretend you're a corpse?
No.
And then she just rides you?
Yeah, what weird fetish.
She's not a necrophiliac, right, Bort?
No.
Yeah.
No, I
she looks at the penises when they come through, though, right?
I can't.
Does she report back?
Hey, yeah. I do have a question about that.
Like, you should have seen this monster that came through today.
Does rigor mortis include the penis?
Rigor mortis includes everything.
Yeah.
Wow.
Okay. Glad I asked.
Okay, so at least I'm presentable.
Yeah.
Well,
exactly.
Well, hopefully.
I had a family member that worked at a police station, and she told me that they would hold up photos of, like, look at this dead guy's penis.
Are you really?
Sure? Oh, I don't like that.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I know Bort can't really talk about it, but, my ex-wife used to work at a bank, and I've mentioned this before. They used to look up everybody's accounts.
Oh, totally.
They put, like, names of people in there that they knew or famous people or try to... I think it's different now, like, to get into the accounts, but they would always do that.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
I have friends at banks that would do that, but that was, like... late 90s, early 2000s.
Yeah. Meanwhile, all my jobs are, I work at a pizza place. I can have free pizza.
Right.
Nothing exciting.
Yeah.
Well, I have a horrible transition. But
what were we talking about that launched into that? Oh,
Liam Payne.
And about how he died forever ago, and now they're just doing the funeral.
Got it.
I'm like, how the hell do we...
Yeah, Bort knows. We have some pretty exciting food news, depending on how much you like condiments.
Love them.
McDonald's just announced that the McRib will return Tuesday, December 3rd. Oh, nothing. But for a limited time, there is a twist. Now you will be able to buy a McRib and an entire half gallon of McRib sauce.
Yeah, I saw that.
The tubs of McRib sauce will go on sale 10 a.m. Monday, November 25th. So get ready, everybody.
It's hard to get one.
It's kind of like when we bought the gallon bottles of the Papa John's garlic butter sauce.
Mm-hmm.
And then Randy and Seabass were drinking them. And that's where we got all our puke sounds.
Oh, my God.
Yep.
That was from drinking the Papa John's sauce. Like, just directly out of a big gallon jug. Yeah.
Oh,
yuck. Do you think the puking started because of, like, just the idea that they were doing it, or their stomach literally filled up with butter, garlic sauce?
Yeah, both. Probably, yeah. It was, yeah.
It's all gurgling.
We're going to take a quick break. We got some more Woody's show next. Hang on. The Woody
right back. That's all I needed to hear. Alt 98.7 LA.